So we have already started taking clients for fall 2025 applications, and I roughly stop taking clients once I have enough, or in fact after September anyway. And the reason for that is, even though fall deadlines may go up till, let's say, February or March, but I do believe you should submit your applications early enough to have maximum chances of success. Now, whether you work with us or not, I do want the audience on this channel to put up a very, very strong application for Masters in US for next fall. And so what are the things you need to do that is what I want to cover in this video. So previously, we have already talked about the total cost of Masters in US in last video. Check it out. Today, I'm going to talk about the exact timeline that you need to follow. So the checklist of item and by when you need to finish those to put up a strong application. I'm going to do this video in two parts. Today, I want to cover the January to August time frame, and in next video, I will talk about everything you need to complete from September onwards. So save this checklist and make sure you get everything done on time to maximize your chances of the dream admits that you want. Let's get started. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel and thanks once again for joining us. Today we are talking about fall 2025 checklist, and first of all, fall sessions start in August. This is the main intake session and all universities accept applications for fall. To get a good and right admission for your profile, you need to start working almost 1.5 years in advance. So to target fall 2025, ideally you should start working on your applications by January 2024. And today we are talking about the January to August checklist items. Now before we begin, don't forget to subscribe because we have a lot of exciting new content coming up to help you with studying abroad and also save money while doing that. Okay, so let's get back to our checklist. Now I'm going to divide this in multiple time frames. The first time frame I'm talking about is January to May. Okay, this is the time where I want you to spend introspecting on your profile, on your goals, do a little bit of profile building and make sure that overall you have a profile which is presentable for masters in good universities. So first thing you want to do is understand your career goals, because to pick the right master's program, you want to be clear about what you want to achieve after masters. So once you have good and well-defined career goals, you will be able to pick the correct master's program for yourself. Now, if the goal is just to get to US somehow, then you can also pick up a program that makes sense with your background while giving you good job options. Then what I would do is start looking at top 100 universities in your field. You can also research other countries if you're planning to apply anywhere else apart from US. For this, I would look at the top QS ranks and shortlist the countries and some universities based on the prospects, location, and any other factors which matter to you. Next, you should be reaching out to seniors, alumni, or your network to find out more information about these programs. I would recommend that you join an expert admissions consultant or mentor for timely and appropriate guidance. Where these consultants can help you is actually save some time. Of course, you can do it by yourself as well, but especially if you're working full time, then you can get help from someone who is a specialist in this area. If you join somebody, then please do make sure that they have been able to get the kind of results for their clients that you are aiming for. Now let's look at the June to August time frame. This is the time frame where you want to start building an idea of like, where exactly am I applying, and let's start looking at the application items. So the first thing you want to do here is, and by the way, like, you know, this is something that you can start doing now. So you want to start with creating an initial shortlist of universities to apply. So based on budget, location, ranking, etc., you should be creating an initial list of, let's say, 20 to 35 universities which seem appropriate to your profile as well as aspirations. Next thing you want to do is finish GRE, at least the first attempt for it, and you want to send free score reports to 4 universities in from the list that you had shortlisted already. Next thing you want to do is also finish TOEFL. Your test fee includes up to 4 free official TOEFL score reports to be sent to the institutions of your choice. However, you can add or delete recipients through your ETS account until 10 p.m. on the day before your test. So, by shortlisting the university before, what we have done is we have a good idea of some universities we are targeting, so that you can send these free GRE and TOEFL test reports to them and obviously save some money there. Next step you can do is get your college transcripts. Especially if you have already graduated, then why delay, right? Because sometimes these formalities can take time. So make sure you talk to your college people and do whatever formality required for getting the transcripts. Now start narrowing down the list of the universities and create a second shortlist based on your test scores. So once you have an idea of what your GRE scores and TOEFL scores are looking like, then you can narrow down your university list further based on those. Next step is reach out to professors in your target universities. I highly recommend this step, especially if you have a research profile. Essentially, what you are doing is you are reaching out to professors who are doing work in areas which are relevant to you or where you have done some sort of a project and expressing an interest in working with them in future. In some rare cases, we have seen that if the professor really likes your profile, then they can recommend you for admissions directly. So yes, it's a very minute possibility, but if it happens, then it's a massive, massive gain for us. So if you think you have a great research profile, then there's no harm in reaching out to professors in your field. Next step is shortlist people for writing LORs for your applications. Now, for masters in US, we need 3 LORs, and it has to be a good mix of academic, professional LORs, etc. We have covered this in detail, by the way, in our LOR masterclass. Do go through it if you're looking for more guidance here. In this time frame, you want to have a good idea of who is going to write your LORs. And what you want to do is next is to reach out and get confirmation from these people. For example, if somebody is not available, you want to have a backup person who you can ask for the LORs instead. So do take their permissions, confirmation, and you can also ask them if they will be writing the LORs themselves or do they want you to draft something or you to give them a list of points that needs to be covered in the LOR. So have that initial conversation with them so that you are not in a panic state later on. Next, I would do is start thinking about your story for the SOP. Now, SOPs are a very important component of your application, and the problem is that they take time. You simply cannot rush them. So yes, by July, August, you should start planning all the things that you are going to write in there. With my clients, I start much early. In fact, we have done a couple of rounds of SOP reviews already with a few clients. But no need to panic if you haven't. You can start this process ASAP now. And the point is to let the ideas come into your head and you start building a narrative of how to present your candidature to the admission committee. If you're not working with us or struggling in this writing phase, then do check out our SOP masterclass, which can give you some crucial pointers to do this process correctly. By the end of August, you want to have a good sense of which universities you're going to apply to and who your recommenders are. So this is the checklist of items that ideally you should complete by August so that you can position yourself strongly for fall 2025 applications and admits. What happens from September onwards, and there are many, many things. So from September to next summer, what are all the things that you need to do? That is what I will be covering in the second part of this video. So make sure you stay subscribed, and if you have any questions about today's video or any other feedback or suggestions for us, then please don't forget to mention them in the comments below. I look forward to seeing your responses. So that was it from my side. We will be covering the next video soon, and of course many more videos are going to come on the application process and scholarships, etc. So stay tuned, and I will see you guys with a fresh new video next weekend. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.